Firstly, happy Independence Day to all of you. I am Leo Omkar Bhosle, President of Leo Club Kandil Western Express. Welcome you all to witness such amazing and interactive session on Free the Fear You Have Caged Within by Ms. Sakshi Pandit. Here are some of the credentials of Ms. Sakshi Pandit. She was Miss India Brain Beauty 2019, a final year mass media student, youngest charter president at Rotary Club of Mumbai Worldwide, youth service director at Rotary District 3141, president 2018 at Rotary Club of Bombay Kandivali, club ambassador, lady representative and student of the year. Also, she has kickstarted her dream initiative, Fund Self Doubt, on National Education Day that aims to inspire the youth to be a star quality, to rise and shine, to crush the fear and to learn the art of balancing. So now we'll start with our session. Over to you, Ms. Sakshi, please.
Thank you so much, Omkar. Thank you. Firstly, a very happy Independence Day to each one and a very good evening to all of you present here. So before I really begin with my session, it's not really a session where, you know, I'll be giving you on what to do, what not to do, or how to just, you know, vanish a fear, because these are things that we experience on our own and we are the only one who will find a solution to it. So rather, it's going to be a pretty interactive session, and I will make sure that I hope that all of my journey, my experience, whatever I'm going to share with you today, connects you with all your heart. So before I really begin with the session, thank you so much, Leo Omkar and Leo Pranali, and all of you today who are present here, for inviting me for such a fantastic topic that is very close to my heart. And before we dive in, I would love if we all would give a small tribute with a 2-minute silence to everyone who have been protecting us fearlessly, be it anywhere in the world, be it our heroes and be it our leaders. So please, requesting you all to mute yourself and for 2 minutes, just pray for their strength and pray for their families. All right. So that might be less than two minutes, but yes, thank you so much. And let me begin with my session. I have especially designed this for you, jotting all the important things that I wish to share with you, because I'm of your same age. You know, we are like, we'll be connecting even more easily than anyone else. So my session is divided into 3 parts. The very first part is where I'll be sharing with you how I reached the stage. Now, often we know leaders, so we are aware of the positions, but we don't really know how they have reached to such an extent. Yes, there are leaders who share the journey of from where they have come. We have amazing, prominent leaders who do share their life journey. But us, we are so rooted. I mean, we all are, you know, you're connecting each other. So I would love to share how I have reached the stage, my transformation journey with you. Then I'm going to share with you the 8 powerful points that we must have heard, we must have read, but we must have not applied themselves, you know, implemented in our life. So I'm going to share with you. And in the end, I'm going to end it with one promise and the 3 most powerful statements that I share with everyone whom I meet. So yes, do keep your questions ready. Please don't go blank. I don't wish to drain your energy. I want it to be very exciting. And so let's dive in. So, you know, I always begin my sessions with my gradual teen days. And I think I was very opposite to what teenagers are today. I mean, we all are, you know, our generation has shifted so drastically that the teens of today are very different from the teens of whom we were. Now, like any other teen, my gradual teen days were pathetic, in short. Now I'll tell you why. I was in a hostel in fourth, and then I was shifted to a day scholar school for fifth and sixth grade. And the most annoying part was that I was a pleasant, plumpy kid and very shy and introvert. I was pretty lost in my own world. I did not really have any goals as such. Where people used to really play during recess, I used to find a spot which was very quiet and, you know, somewhere very lonely, and I used to have my snacks on my own. And the most terrible time were where, you know, day scholar schools, we are forced to sit with a bench partner whom we are not allowed to choose, but we have to bear them for the entire grade, and especially when they're so annoying. So that was my gradual teen days. And I was bullied because I think I could never speak up or something. And I used to hate studying. I used to only look at teachers walking in the classroom, teaching something, and then walking back. I never understood that, you know, what's the importance of really scoring well. I was a backbencher, and those were the pathetic days of my life. But then the 2 years drained my energy, and I wanted to do something on my own. I took my own decision, which I'm even presently thankful for. And the decision was to go back to my hostel days. Now, this is not a solution, but you have to take a step on your own when you think and you feel you cannot grow in a surrounding, or you cannot grow in an environment that is not helping you or inspiring you. So I took the decision of my life to, you know, go back to my hostel days and try to discover myself. Let me tell you, that wasn't it. It wasn't really a most amazing decision, but that was a start to my journey. I remember that my parents were pretty worried about me, because hostel life, you know, right? It's everyone says that people who are naughty are put in hostels. But here I wanted to go on my own. And, you know, you must have seen Tare Zameen Par. So that was the hostel where I was in Panjgani, Newera High School. And after I went there, though I had made friends and knew my friends and everything, I was homesick. I was missing home. And I did not know what to do, but I still went on. Now, a person in the gradual teen days hated sports, hated studies. Here in my school, I was forced to wake up, like, not forced, it was a routine, to wake up early in the morning to go for jogging, to go for cross countries and marathons. And I had never done that. So now I was again lost. I was like, oh my God, you know, I have never been to, I've never been for sports. I didn't like sports at all. But here I discovered myself. I discovered my potential. The hate for sports turned into love for sports. I started finding my potential. I started discovering what I'm good at. I remember a girl who used to not speak up, who did not know what leadership is. I started trying to speak up and trying to interact with more people, especially my teachers. And from a monitor, I was then promoted to a sub-captain. And then from a sub-captain, I was promoted to a prefect. So that's how my leadership skills developed. And that's how I discovered that there is some leadership qualities in me. Now, I was never on stage. I was never a person who loved dancing or who loved singing, who loved elocutions or anchoring. But even then, the gradual days helped me discover that I'm good at, you know, stage performances. So I went on for anchoring and taking charge of my assemblies. And that's how I started loving stage too. Now, imagine, even after all these things, the next phase of my life comes where I have to leave my hostel days and come to live in Mumbai. Now, how funny, right? Like, my past, my gradual teens as a Mumbaikar wasn't that pleasant. So I did not wish to stay in Mumbai again. But despite all of the, again, stressful things, I made myself understand, and I settled in Mumbai for my college days. Now, you know, during our 10th stand and 9th stand, that is a phase where teachers emphasize on why you should study hard and why you have to get good grades. I was lost. I did not know why we have to study Han, because I never liked studying. I always used to mug up history and geography, and all these subjects were stressful, especially maths. It used to just not make me feel peaceful at all. But after I left 10th and I went for my 11th standard grade, I understood the importance of education. That there was so much of competition to get in a good college because of the grades. And if you don't have good grades, you will not get into a good reputed college. And that's what happened with me. With passing with 74%, I was in Malad, and I never traveled because of hostel. You know, we had to just walk a few kilometers to reach a school building or a hostel, dormitory. But then Mumbai, in my 11, 12, the senior college, it helped me understand traveling. It helped me observing. It helped me connecting to people and understanding how they also come from a background and how their struggles are. So yes, service, if you talk about, which is very common in Leo, Rotaract, Rotary, Lions Club, which we do and which we are trying to do. This was inbuilt ever since I was born, because my family's upbringing helped me that way. And I followed my family's footsteps. So whenever I used to see an animal in help, I used to help them. It's our natural human tendency, right? If we see anyone in need, we try and go help them. And after that, my crucial days of graduation appeared. No doubt, I knew what I wanted to do all this while was media. And when I went on to my college, the very first year, I try to understand why people are so excited about like college. Everyone is like, sharing their journey. They're super excited. They're happy. They're jumping and singing. And I'm like, why am I asking the students like this? Like, are they really nuts about it? I tried finding my corner. I tried finding friends. I tried finding some areas where I can be comfortable from. So even despite all of the good things, I also have like a phase where I was still discovering myself. But yes, I was introduced to student council by my professor, and that was a really nice thing in my very first year. My very first year, I also stood first. So ever since I thought that education is important, I was ranking first. I was trying to help more kids out, and I was trying to interact with them on the same topics. And after that, when I joined Rotaract, through one of my best friend, with my mentors, when they saw the enthusiasm and passion in me and the zeal to serve and do something, the very next year I was introduced as the president. Now, I again asked myself that even though I have leadership qualities, no doubt, but handling a club is something, you need experience. That's what I thought. But when they told me about the potential that I had and the support that I would be getting, the life-changing experience that I would go through, I did not want to leave this chance. All I wanted was to connect with people, to make some friends, to do something that I always wanted to do. Now, the very first GBM, general body meetings that we all have, one of my mentors asked me that, which is your dream initiative that you wish to start? And I just knew one thing. I wish to place water pots for the stray dogs in Thakur village, because summer heats were terrible. And they said that, it would take time. It would take a lot of efforts and money. So how would we do it? I knew that I had to do it anyhow. And then I learned a lot of things. So my weakness was sponsoring. But again, I tried approaching a lot of people, and that's how we kickstarted it. Now, in short, the dream initiative was kickstarted into a reality, which has now become a living example for a lot of people even today. And then again, I was introduced as a student council member in my second year. And funny part, second year I went to give my lady representative form, and I get to know that only in the third year you can apply and only the teachers will choose you. And I'm like, I want to reach a stage like that. With again, a lot of guidance and all, luckily the very next year, again, I stood first despite having presidentship. So I never believed in, just focusing on one area, trying to plan it out and doing everything that you want to do. So despite presidentship, having a lot of load of initiatives and meetings and a lot of things, I still was rooted with my studies and still giving it time, and I stood first. Now, the very next day, I was again introduced as a lady representative. and the youngest Tata president. Now, again, for youngest Tata president, it was very funny because opening a Rotary club is like opening a new Leo club, and it's a burden again. You feel like you are just on a stage where you decide to join, your parent club. Well, at the age of say 30, and at the age of 20, you are being introduced to being a charter president of a Rotary club. That was funny. So despite all of those, no doubt it needed a lot of efforts, a lot of time, a lot of hard work, a lot of convincing to get members. We did it, and this is the second year of our charter club, and I'm super proud. Okay, now of all the roles that I played in my life, super jumbling, super confusing. Now coming to my wish, what I really wish to do. Now, I always wanted to go into pageant. Having a height that is restricted in, official pageants, I knew that I couldn't fit into a pageant world where you have height restrictions, you have weight restrictions, you have so many things that you have to go through. But I knew that I wanted to groom myself and even experience that stage. I was introduced to Miss India Brainy Beauty as an ad. I thought to myself, will I really be able to do it? I went on with it. I went for the auditions, but I didn't just go for it. I remember having a clumsy ramp walk, wanting to do fashion walks, but not really having the confidence to do so, because I always saw the competition with those slim girls and tall girls and skinny people, the beauty myths. And then when I groomed myself, I did not teach myself under any trainer. Rather, I taught myself with the trainers on social media through YouTube. So that helped me groom myself and understand the importance of grooming and nurturing your weaknesses. And that's how I also cracked another title for winning the crown. Now, this platform gave me another beautiful era of my dream, another dream initiative, which I will be introducing you to a later stage. So this was my entire journey. So in a circle, in short, if you must have missed out on anything because it's confusing, from a girl who did not know what to do, to trying to take decisions step by step, to following the path and creating the journey, that's what I learned. And even today, it's not like I don't feel lost. It's not like I'm not scared. It's not like I'm not nervous. We are not perfect. Everyone, whoever comes for speaking also are nervous. So yes, it's all about creating a path and designing a journey, trying to experience and exploring a potential. This was the very first segment of mine. And now I will be jumping on to my second segment. I hope, Omkar, it was all clear enough, and I hope it's connecting with everyone.
Yes, yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Now, the very second phase that I have are the 8 powerful points. Now, why I shared my journey, it's not to really tell you of whom I am, but also to help you connect with me, of letting you know a life experience that can help you find your own potential. Now, the 8 powerful points that I share with anyone whom I meet with, and these are especially designed for even you. So the very first one, and this is going to be really different. So you all can grab your pen, your notebook, your notepad or diary or anything that you wish, you want to note down, because it's going to be very helpful. So the very first one, the journey is yours. Make the most out of it. This is a quote that I had written when I had won my pageant, and I really believe in it. It's because every individual on this earth is different. Everyone's timings are different. Everyone's situations are different. Everyone's surroundings are different. Potentials are different. So, it's your journey. You are born. Be respectful to that. You are having a shelter. You're having a supportive family. Whatever your situation might be, it's yours. So, no one is going to steal away and tell you that, oh my God, we are similar to each other. There are a lot of interests that match, but this is your journey. So make the most out of it. Try to creating and designing your life the way you want it. Take your own decisions. That's what I tell everybody, even myself. Sometimes a few choices might go wrong and might even make you or break you. Sometimes a few choices might need your guidance, someone else's guidance. So don't be afraid to talk it out or discuss with someone, especially your parents. You think there's a best friend of yours who can listen to you and guide you? Please discuss it out with them. But don't step back with even discussing it with yourself. Number 2, stop complaining. you know, this lockdown has taught us about how much we rant about everything. Like every situation that doesn't happen according to us, every time we are complaining about it. Either why is this sickness happening to me, or why does this cousin behave in a certain manner which we don't like, or why are such people so irritating? We are every now and then just complaining, only ranting about everything. So stop complaining. And to that I would tell, stop comparing and following trends and people. The most entertaining device and platform that has become now is the social media. We look at people and see a lot of likes on people's feed, see how beautiful the profile looks, see how many followers they have and how active they are. And we feel that we belong nowhere. We forget about our discovery. We forget about our potential. There are a lot of things that we forget about. So stop following trends. Make your own stand. 3, be an opportunist. You know, there are a lot of opportunities that might just knock your door, not everyone else's door, at the right time. So be patient and grab them. When something, you know, it's very funny about humans. When something doesn't happen, they wish to complain. Oh, why is this not happening with me? And when something really knocks your door, you ask yourself and doubt whether is it really fit for you. So when opportunities are knocking your door, why not take them? Even if there might be risk available. So find your purpose and abilities, because every one of us here have come with a purpose, right? And if you don't have purpose, your purpose is not clear enough, you will not know what to do. Now, when we join youth wings like Leo Club and Rotra Club, we know our purpose. We wish to connect. We wish to do initiatives. We wish to serve. But even in your personal life, know your purpose. The fourth one, and this is the second quote that I really like. The only real way to really own is in your mind. Now imagine, this is again a funny part. Everything else is just numbers. You know, when we age, we say age is just a number. And similarly, when we have weight, when we have a particular height, they are also just numbers. But when we weigh ourselves, when we check our height and it is not according to what we really thought it was, we become dull, we become lost, we feel like we don't belong here. And we feel like something is wrong with us. So the only weight is in your mind. Stop burdening yourself with so much, you know. Just free yourself with the fear you have. Just free yourself with the burden that you're giving your mind. Now, what is the solution to this? What do we do? So if you fit in this category, even I do that, I overthink a lot. So if you fit into this category, the solution to this is either you accept it, you accept that you're short. That's what I tell myself. You accept that you're gaining weight sometimes. So embrace your flaws. There's nothing wrong in that. Or else change it. Now, there are a lot of times where we don't like how we look. We don't like how we talk. We don't like how we walk. So you can improve all those skills. Try learning more. Try investing in yourself. Or else you just leave it. You don't bother about it. So if there's a problem, you either accept it, you improve it, or you just leave it and stop burdening your mind so much. The fifth point is, this is again a quote that I had written, life is like a video game. You feel proud of your accomplishments, but you also have to have a strong game plan ready to unlock the next phase. Similar to PUBG. When you play PUBG, because it's really famous and a lot of people play, you know, you feel really proud you won a chicken dinner and you unlocked the next phase. But again, you know, with your teammates, you individually also, along with the players that you're playing with, you try to make a strong game plan ready so that you can kill those people and, you know, unlock a next level. So similar to this is a life. Always plan. It's good to go with the flow, but I believe that if this pandemic had hit those people who have never planned, who have never thought of the future, I think they're the most hit people. So always plan, make notes of what you truly want to do. Even if the situation isn't apt, know what you want to do because that might happen next. So make your next move very wisely. The sixth point and quote four, the last quote, change your antenna. Our devices, when they lost network, when they don't have connection, when they don't have a proper Wi-Fi connection or a network, or they're out of range, it does not work properly, right? It does not let you connect with someone else or, you know, use your WhatsApp or any other application that requires the Wi-Fi, right? Similar to this as a mind. When we lose our network, we lose our energy or our confidence, we are not able to function well. So why not change our antenna from the negative channel to a positive channel? You know, are you aware of if that one thought, or one positive thought, or one positive word in your day can have an impactful solution to everything that that you're facing? So why burden your mind, and rather why think about the dullness that you have, and not rather, you know, think of a solution? So instead of thinking, I cannot do this, or I am not good at it, or, you know, I might not be capable enough, change your sentences, change your antenna. Tell yourself, I want to do this. I can do this. I wish to do this. So even if it is about a small task, like for example, you have to wash the utensils. That's what your mom says, and you hate it, but you don't have a choice. So you tell yourself, I want to wash the utensils.
Sakshi, you're not audible. Sakshi. Sakshi.
Just put a message, Omkar.
A lot of ideas. We have a lot of things that we want to do, but we are scared. Now, in the lockdown, I had done a live session with Daily Dump about composting, on how to do composting in offices or workplaces or home. Now, if I would have kept this idea to myself, I don't think so this would benefit a lot of them. So I approached them first, and it was really nice how I connected with them, because I thought they would deny. Now, if I would assume that, my live session would never be possible. So I approached them, and then I collaborated with more clubs. I always tell people, don't keep your ideas, your experiences, your incidents to yourself. If you do something, if you come across something which is tough, which is good, which is, you know, to be celebrated for, share it with people. You don't know when this might connect with someone. And then the art of balancing. There are a lot of times where after approaching is done, collaborating is done, you think that you have to focus only on that part. And that's a no-no situation. It depends on everyone, individual to individual. But I always believe that if you make a schedule and if you plan accordingly, you will be able to do everything. So learn the art of approaching, collaborating, and balancing. And the very last point, this is a very good thing, that fear is like a virus. It enters from your mind, it goes in your organs very quickly, and you know, corrupts all of them. So when there's fear, you cannot speak, you feel scared, you feel lost, you cannot move, your hands shake. So what is the antivirus solution to it? The antivirus to this is hashtag punch self-doubt. Stop doubting yourself, even though the word is so simple. So just stop doubting yourself. Believe in yourself. It might take some time, but I'm sure that all these points will help you to believe in yourself, to gain some confidence, and to discover your true potential. Now, my pageant gave me another platform to kickstart this journey of hashtag punch self-doubt. I used to visit a lot of BMC schools, and I used to connect with a lot of schools and colleges and talk to kids, because our teenage days were the worst, or even if they were blossoming, I think now the teens require us. We are the role models. And therefore, share your skills with someone else. That's what my initiative believes in. If you're good in dancing, if you're good in singing, if you're good in art, if you're good in speaking, try connecting and sharing these skills with someone else. So for example, if Omkar is good in speaking, you know, and or dancing, and I don't like dancing or singing. But if someone keeps a session, I would love to attend, because I have never discovered those qualities in me. But I think someone else might help me discover them. Similarly, it begins from your home. The entire platform now has shifted digitally. Imagine your parents and your grandparents and your siblings are so lost that they don't know how this technological world functions. So you, the mastermind, can share some skills and help them. It might need a lot of patience because we quickly understand it. They do not. So why not just spend some time and help them share those skills and discover their potential? So this was all, and it went really quick. I hope I did not, I wasn't too fast or energy draining. I hope all these points connected you. These were the 8 powerful points that I wanted to connect with you. All I want to say is, this is not the ending. Just a few more things before I end it. All I want to say is, keep roaring, Leos. I would rather tell it to everyone. Keep roaring, guys. Keep aiming high. Don't be afraid to be yourself. In today's world, be it an introvert or an extrovert, every individual is unique and beautiful in their own way. There are so many people who are introvert and extrovert, and we try to divide them, but everyone has their own plans. Someone might not share it with you. Someone might really connect with you. So don't judge people. Don't judge yourself. Speak up when needed. And this is really powerful. You know, a lot of times we travel, we see people disobeying the rules, right? Today is Independence Day. We promise ourselves on every Independence Day that I am a responsible citizen. But do we really follow it? It only, you know, flashes and posts really nice on the social media. But do we really follow it as individuals? So I'm not here to tell you what to do or what not to do. But it's the responsibility that we as individuals can take. Now, if it's very simple, if you see someone doing something wrong, very fresh example, if you see someone spitting on the road, isn't it that our duty, if we are the witnesses, isn't it our duty to just politely tell them? And how funny, right? We compare our countries to other countries, how clean they are because their laws are strict. Well, no. Speak up when needed. Don't be afraid. And speak up for someone else when required. A lot of times when I was bullied, I don't think so my classmates really bothered to help me understand, because that phase was different. But today, I know that if someone is bullied, I would go and explain them and, you know, really stand for them. So help one another, which is important. And one promise that I'm going to make, I want you all to make with me today is, this: the end of the session is with one promise and the 3 most powerful sentences. The one promise is that whatever today has connected you with all your heart, please share it with someone else. They might need it. You can share it with your siblings, your parents, your grandparents, with your friends. Whatever has connected with you, please share it with them. That's how we try to be change makers. And the last, the 3 most powerful sentences that I would like to share with you is, whenever you are caught up with a situation, be it anything, be it a small, be it a huge one, whenever you're caught up in a situation which pulls you down, which drains your energy, tell yourself, I can, I will, and I did it. These were the 3 powerful sentences shared with my professor in the 7th grade, and I never forgot it. I did not implement them in my gradual later days, but I do implement them even today. So whenever I feel nervous, I just tell these sentences, and the spark that I get, the confidence that I get is tremendous. Thank you so much. And my dream initiative, #PunSelfDoubt, all I want to tell is that it aims to connect with more youth, with ones who have overcome their fears and who are trying to strive and achieve and be change makers. So please do connect with me. Do interact with me. Do share your journey, because I would love to share your journey with someone else. So thank you so much. This was all. I hope every word connected with you. I hope I did not lose network or connection. And thank you, Omkar.
Thank you, Sakshi. Guys, yes.
Hello.
Guys, in doubt, can you ask this? Yes. I would like you, Mantha. No, I'm audible. I would like our political district president, Leo Manthan, to speak for 2 minutes. Manthan.
Can you hear me? Just a minute. I was in some different session as well. So just hold on.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. So I'm in an installation and I was connected. I'm so sorry. So Omkar, congratulations to the entire KWE for this brilliant event. I'm sorry, I'll be very open about it. I wasn't there for the full time. But I would love to see the recording of this thing for sure. And I'm more than happy to see the recording of this thing for sure. So, I mean, just share it with me and I'll be more than willing to see it for sure. And many congratulations to Omkar and the entire club and keep doing such wonderful events.
Thank you, Manu. Yes, so thank you so much, Ms. Sakshi, for such an amazing and interesting session. It gives us in detail information that how we should overcome our fear from all possible ways. Also, I would like to thank all the participants who have attended this session. Also, the contact details of Ms. Sakshi Pandey to share in chat box. Also, I would like to mention some special guests. Ritika Pujari, a Leo president. Hello, yeah, what happened? Yeah, Ms. Sitika Pujari, Leo President of Malad Borovli, Leo Vinay Dalmia, President of Leo Sports Warriors, Leo Shamika Zogile, District PR, Grand PRO, and all Leo members. Thank you so much for attending this session. Thank you so much. Yeah. Sakshi, can you?
Pardon? Thank you so much, everyone, and do connect with me. And yes, thank you all, and I hope you all discover your own journey and potential. Happy Independence Day once again.